Boom. And we made it to Friday. From the garage under my parents' house at the base of the Santa Monica Mountains, this is Ham Radio Now, episode number 418, Self-Quarantine, Day 4. Made it to Friday. Said that already. 4 days of quarantine. We're still here. We're still alive. There's still food in the house. We've got toilet paper. Everything is good to go. Good to go. Thanks for tuning in for another day. We've got some good feedback on day one and two. Sadly, last night, day three, we just was a long, long day of work and didn't get it to make it out here to the shack. But this Friday, got nothing to do tomorrow but quarantine some more. So I'm going to stay up late. We're going to have a little episode. Ham radio. So I asked folks, what should I talk about while I'm sitting here in my garage and I got nothing better to do? What kind of ideas? What topics? Whatever. So have some DX stuff out there. I've got some CW requests out there. And have some comments about what are we doing with ham radio right now? I wonder, what are you doing? I got plans this weekend. I'm going to put dipole up. It's been a while since I had an antenna up. We put a she shed in the backyard and I need to take the pole down that had my old antenna up on it. But I'm going to put something up for the time being because why not? It's there. And ham radio is the opportunity for me to reach out beyond the property lines here and talk to some folks, hopefully near and far as well. So that's my plan. A bunch of you folks responded back from the different areas where I post content talking about what you were doing. Betsy up north said they were helping out in their county call center. I think that's awesome. You know, that's what hams do. We step up and we help in times of need. I saw some other groups online, some of the Facebook groups. Some hams, some CERT folks were helping with drive-through lunch pickups for kids that aren't in school that are used to getting free meals. I think that's an awesome thing. And I saw in some areas even they're helping with some of the drive-through testing. I don't know. I might be a little afraid of that. But I'm glad you're all stepping up and doing things and getting out there and helping the community. That's what we should be doing. I've asked in our general vicinity, and so far there's not a lot for us to do, but we are ready. We are prepared. And as I talked about in the last episode, I have looked through my bags of stuff to go, and they're ready if they need to be. I'm going to switch over the battery charger to the next battery tomorrow, make sure that that's got a good charge to it. We got one more to cycle through for the month. And get that going just in case we're asked to step up. But I wonder, for the rest of you out there that I hadn't heard from, what are you doing? Are there things for hams to do right now? Is it just hobby time? Are we going to get our DX on this weekend? I did see some of the other podcasters that do the ham radio thing. We're talking about getting some nets together across the country, and some of the other podcasters we're talking about getting together for a show on a secret HF frequency so they didn't get a lot of jammers and record something as well. I'm not sure if that's this weekend or next, but there'll be some content coming to you. And I think that's a great idea. And I think you should get out there and, you know, whether it's, local UHF, VHF or getting out in the HF and just reaching out to other hams out there. I know that there are probably a lot of lonely hams that are stuck in quarantine now and up and down the coasts, and there's probably a lot of hams out there in the middle of the country that this quite hasn't touched yet, but it may be coming to you guys soon. So make some contacts, and you could talk to some folks out of the area that might be in a situation like I am in Los Angeles County, where, you know, we're supposed to stay in and not go anywhere and just kind of take it easy. I've been working at home, day four of my self-quarantine. This is my fourth day of working at home this week. Usually it's the other way around. Usually I stay home one day a week and I go to the office the other four. And we've been real fortunate at my company. We've had very, very few challenges around that. And it's worked pretty well, and I'm glad that it worked out. It's actually going to give me a little bit more time to be out here and to talk ham radio with you. So we're going to do that. I'm going to get the radio that's back there over there under the pile of stuff uncovered. I'm going to get my Yaesu and I'm going to put up a 40-meter and maybe even an 80-meter dipole so I have some night and day action. And I'm going to see what I can find out there see who's out there working HF, and talk to you all about what's going on in the amateur radio. And I might actually move some of the cameras over there. I got a really cool setup. I bought an SDR radio that plugs into the back of my Yaesu HF radio, and using Ham Radio Deluxe, the free version, I get a full pan adapter, and got a laptop over there set up for it. It's real cool. I might actually do a little show on what it took to put all that together, and it's neat. I can use the laptop to control the rig. It'll take me to whatever frequency I want. I can see a full spectrum because the HD radio I have is a little bit older, doesn't have the full waterfall. It has a small waterfall, but not the full waterfall on it. Just makes it a little easier for me to see what's going on out there. So I'm gonna fire that up and see what that looks like. Again, looking at the go box behind me, it's ready to go in case there's a situation or an issue going there. I might pull that out and clean out the back. I think there's a spider or two living in there because it sits on the counter most of the time. Make sure it's ready to go. Put it on the batteries for a couple hours and check that thing out. So in the Facebook group, if you're there, or even on the YouTube channel, tell me what you're up to. Tell me what your weekend of amateur radio or ham radio is going to be like. Are you worried about this? Are you getting prepared? You got all your stuff together, or is it just another day in paradise for you and you're not worried about this yet? I will tell you honestly here, we're kind of worried, but we're pretty much staying here. Mom and Dad haven't left the house except to walk around the block, and I'm here, and the kids seem to be doing okay. School from home thing that they're working through. And probably get them out here and have them play a little radio too. Everybody here in the house, six of the seven members of my household, all have their tickets. I don't think my mom ever will, but that's okay. She may change her mind after all this. But I'll get some of them to maybe play a little radio with me. What else came up in the Facebook group? I did see there's some of the Aries groups are going to have an radio meetings. Instead of their monthly get-together face-to-face, they're starting to do some of those over RF. I think that's a great idea, and I was going to talk to our DEC here in the LA area to see if can't really cover the whole area on RF, and it makes it a little difficult with the duplex effect or the non-duplex effect to be able to get through traffic and talking and whatever we'll have for meeting topics. But I'm thinking about hosting a Zoom session and see how many of the folks from our regular meeting, we have usually the first Saturday of the month, we can get into a Zoom chat and at least spend a little time together to talk about what we'd be going on. This next coming Monday would have been the Baker to Vegas race, and they had postponed that. It's usually end of March or early April, and because all those first responders are really busy helping our community, all the law enforcement officers, they moved that back to October. First weekend in October, we'll be heading out to Death Valley there to spend a couple of days on the weekend to help them out. I'm looking forward to that. I'm glad they didn't just up and cancel the whole event. We'll still have it this year, just be time shifted a little bit. But yeah, we'll see what our meeting looks like this month. It was a little odd on our net last week on Monday night. We changed up the format. Usually we do check-ins and we take some traffic. And this week we just decided to just do traffic and skip the check-ins. Mostly went pretty well. There were a couple of kind of off the wall questions about who's got what and what do we do to be safe. And I'm worried that some of those questions are going to kind of go off the rails. So we'll see what next Monday night's check-ins look like. It may just be straight traffic, or we may go back to check-ins. I'm kind of interested in seeing who's actually there and who's coming to the net every week. I got my notebook and I kind of keep filling it up every week. Got a couple of versions on the shelf here from the past couple of years of doing nets. But I want to see if everybody's still checking in, if they're still interested, if while they're in their quarantine, it's worthwhile them to go out to their shack or sit on the couch and pull out an HT and still participate in the net. It's an important thing. So we're going to do that. I don't think we'll have too many other events throughout the month, but you know, you never know. We may get activated in Los Angeles County here again. We typically support the hospital systems if they start to have communication failures for whatever reason. We could get called, and I know our DEC has said very strictly, if we are called to help out, we're supposed to work outside the building as much as we can and relay traffic outside of the hospitals to the medical aid center. That's the group that provides information for the ambulance traffic. That's one of the big roles that we play in a disaster, letting them know how many beds are available and how much traffic they can take and the current situation of the hospital. So we'll see what that looks like. So I guess the rest of it is just, you know, again, putting the call out to you. What do you want to see? If you have a special part of amateur radio that's important to you and you know a bit about it, and it doesn't have to be tons, drop me a note. My call sign, Whiskey Zero Delta Hotel Golf at ARRL.net. Send me a note. Maybe you'd be willing to sit in front of your laptop for half an hour or so and talk to me about what that is. All you need is a laptop and a webcam and an okay internet connection. It doesn't need to be super good. And, you know, we'll share your little slice of amateur radio. I've had a lot of conversations over the couple of years I've been working with Gary on the show. We had the director of FEMA, or I guess the ex-director of FEMA on. We've had folks that do the traffic nets on. We've had folks that do software for training for your tests on. We've had folks that, you know, make cables on and antennas and all sorts of different things. We've had folks that help out in Aries, Mars, Races. We've had cert folks on. Whatever it is, if it's interesting to you and it's amateur radio, I'd be really sure, be happy to spend a little time talking to you about it. And as this crisis grows, I'm getting the sense that a lot of people are going to be kind of in my situation where they're going to be stuck at home for a period of time. So maybe I can help you pass an afternoon by a little faster by having you on and bringing, you know, your little slice of amateur radio to the rest of the world. Don't really have much more tonight. I'm working on a little bit more for the weekend. I have a potential guest lined up if we can get it all together. So again, I want to thank you. I'm back, and I'm going to try to be back, like I said, on a pretty regular basis. And maybe even Gary will come visit. So with that, I will thank you all for joining me. This was Ham Radio Now, episode number 418, self-quarantine, day 4. And look forward to seeing you again. This is W0DHG, over and out.